Bismillah, Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala Rasulillah. Let us start with the most beloved words to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the most beloved statements to Allah are four. It doesn't matter which one you start with. That is, you may start with any of these four. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. You know the meanings already. Subhanallah. Subhanallah means glorified is Allah. Subhanallah, glorified is Allah. Or Allah is free from defects and deficiencies. Walhamdulillah, all the praises and thanks are for Allah. Wala ilaha illallah. Wala ilaha, and there is no God illa except. Illallah, except Allah. Wallahu Akbar, and Allah is the greatest. We speak thousands of words every day. Most of them are perhaps useless. This hadith gives four statements that will lift us and those around us spiritually and morally and bring us eternal rewards. They will increase our faith and develop love and greatness of Allah in our hearts. Let's take brief explanations. Subhanallah. That is, Allah is free from any defect or deficiency. He needs no one as a partner. His commands are perfect. His tests that we are going through are also perfect. We just beg Him that He helps us pass the tests. Alhamdulillah. Say the dhikr with alternating feelings, because hamd has two meanings, praise and thanks. So sometimes praising Allah for His attributes as are reflected in His creations. Or thanking Allah for the blessings that we enjoy. And thanking Allah for the blessings that we enjoy. La ilaha illallah. There's no God, there's no ilah except Allah. So we have to focus on the meanings of the word ilah. Ilah has different meanings. For example, the one who is worshipped, the one who fulfills our needs, and the one who is obeyed. Try to keep these different meanings in mind while reciting it. Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. Greatest in all excellent attributes. We can think of each of the 99 attributes of Allah and realize His greatness. Let's take two statements. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, there are two statements that are light for the tongue, heavy in the scales, and are dear to the merciful. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanallah al-azim. Subhanallah, glory be to Allah. Or more precisely, Allah is free from defects and deficiencies. Okay, that is subhanallah. Wa bihamdihi has four words in it. Wa means and, bi means with, hamd means all praise and thanks, wa bihamdihi, and with His praise. Wa bihamdihi, and with His praise. That is, Allah is free from defects as well as He is full of praise. And hamd means thanks also. Subhanallah, of course, you know, glory be to Allah, al-azim, the mighty, the magnificent. The first two words, subhanallah and bihamdihi, are explained earlier. Here in the second sentence, subhanallah al-azim, we have azim, and it's a very important aspect of praising Allah. Allah is azim, that means He, which implies His strength and power in His entity as well as in His attributes. Let's take a treasure from the treasures of Jannah. Abu Musa Ash'ari radiyallahu anh reported, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to me, shall I not guide you to a treasure from the treasures of Jannah? I said, yes, O Messenger of Allah. Thereupon he said, recite, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. A man can have house, car, clothes, and many other things, but the treasure is the most valuable of them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam called these words, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, as a treasure of Jannah. That means they are very special in the sight of Allah. What's the meaning of La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah? Hawl means strength. La hawl means there is no strength. La hawl, there is no strength. Wala quwa. Quwa is power. Wala quwa. Wa means and. La, no. Quwa, power. Wala quwa and no power. Illa billah. Illa means except. Okay. Billahi, with Allah. Except with Allah. La hawla wala quwata illa billah. That is staying away from the evil, giving up the evil and the will to repent is not possible at all without the help of Allah. On the other side, tawfiq, the power to do good deeds and sticking to them, for example, to offer salah daily in time is not at all possible without the help of Allah. That is, there is no strength to stay away from the evil and no power to do good deeds except with Allah's help. Everything is possible by the help of Allah only. Cure from illness, protection from poverty and troubles, and success in all tasks are possible with the help of Allah only. And how should we recite this? With humility, like the one who begs for Allah's help and protection. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Especially when you see a person who is doing wrong things, don't feel, you know, great about yourself. So I should say, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, meaning, oh Allah, if I am away from the sins, it is because of your mercy, because of the power that you, and if I am doing good deeds, it is because of the power you gave me. Let's take the best dhikr. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best of what I and the prophets before me have said is, La ilaha illallah, wahdahu, la sharika lahu, lahul mulku, wa lahul hamdu, wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. While reciting it, we may sometimes remember the greatest and the most noble people of the world, that is the prophets. Why? Because that's what the prophet said. The best of what I and the prophets before me have said is this dhikr. In another hadith, the prophet ﷺ said, he who utters 100 times in a day these words, La ilaha illallah, wahdahu, la sharika lahu, lahul mulku, wa lahul hamdu, wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir, he will have a reward equivalent to that for emancipating 10 slaves. 100 good deeds will be recorded to his credit. 100 of his sins will be blotted out from his scroll. And he will be safeguarded against the devil on that day till the evening. And no one will exceed him in doing more excellent good deeds except someone who has recited these words more often than him. MashaAllah, amazing dhikr. La ilaha illallah. There is no God except Allah. That is simple, you know that. Wahdahu, he is alone. La means no. Sharik means partner. La sharik, no partner. Lahu, to him. La sharika lahu, no partner to him. Lahul mulku, for him is the kingdom. Al mulk means kingdom. Walahul hamdu, and for him alhamdu, all praise and thanks. Lahul mulku wa lahul hamdu. For him is the kingdom and for him are all praises and thanks. Wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Wa huwa, and he is ala kulli shay'in. Kul means every. Shay means thing. So kul means every and shay means thing. Kullu shay, everything. Ala kulli shay, over everything. Qadir. Qadir means all powerful. And he is over everything, all powerful. Analyze and memorize. So you can memorize this dhikr on two fingers for ease of memorization. You don't have to do like this and it's not a sunnah, but just for ease. And a tip, you know, you can write, you can do different things. So here on the first finger, you have three units. La ilaha illallah, wahdahu, la sharika lahu. On the second one, lahul mulku, wa lahul hamdu, wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. Please visit understandquran.com for our courses on read al-Quran, learn tajweed, and understand al-Quran, and for one-to-one learning. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum.